What are the various tests that one needs to undergo to keep a check on the lifestyle diseases like hypertension, heart attack and diabetes? And at what intervals one needs to go through these tests?
Yeah, that's a very important question. Actually, diabetes and hypertension, we can say that they are introduced in our life very silently. So unless we measure them, we don't know that we have them. For example, hypertension is known as the silent killer. The reason is that many people come to know that they have high blood pressure only when they are suffering from one of its complications. Either they land up in kidney failure or get a heart attack, and then the BP is very high. So what one should do is, for detecting hypertension, I would recommend at the age of 30 onwards, one should at least have his blood pressure checked once by a qualified doctor. For diabetes, it is important to get your sugars checked once. Earlier, it used to be recommended above 40, you should have a health check. But with the kind of scenario we have today, I would say at the age of 30, you should have your check, get yourself checked once at least. So get your sugar checked fasting and post lunch, and see whether they are in the normal limits. For heart attack, of course, heart attack doesn't go unnoticed. You do have symptoms, you have chest pain, you have perspiration. It may not be very typical. People might complain of just acidity or a heaviness in the chest. So it's important to get an ECG done for people who have this kind of a symptom. And the doctor might advise you to get admitted. And there are certain blood tests like troponin I, troponin T. And then there are serial ECGs to be done. If at all they suspect a blockage, then they might advise an angiography. So a heart attack definitely has got its own symptoms, but plain hypertension and diabetes, you need to do a test and find out.
So as a precautionary measure, even if we do not have any symptoms of any diseases, one needs to go through various tests at least once a year, right?
It is good if at all you have some risk factors like a family history of heart disease, family history of diabetes and hypertension. So I would say it's good to get yourself checked annually. If you can manage above 30, get yourself annually checked, it's good. Because nowadays the mean age of having these diseases is reducing.
Is there any correlation between obesity, hypertension, blood pressure, heart attack and diabetes? Aren't they correlated to each other? Like a person who is obese can develop hypertension or blood pressure and blood sugar?
You are absolutely right. They are all interlinked. These lifestyle diseases are all interlinked. A person with obesity has got a risk of getting hypertension as well as diabetes. If it is related to physical activity, then yes, because of lack of physical activity, he might land up in diabetes. And hypertension and diabetes per se are risk factors for heart attack. So they are all interlinked. If you are diabetic, definitely you have a higher chance of cardiovascular diseases, that is either a heart attack or a stroke. If you are hypertensive, again your risk increases. So if at all you make changes in your lifestyle, you are preventing not one but all of these risk factors. So all of these lifestyle illnesses. So making positive changes to your life, in a single stroke you are getting protection against diabetes, against hypertension, against heart disease, against cancers also. So all these are interlinked. Of course, if you have diabetes, later on your blood vessels might narrow and you might get hypertension. But if you are a hypertensive, it doesn't mean that you will get diabetes. The converse is not true. So, and obesity per se is a risk factor for getting hypertension and diabetes both. And if you have either of these, then again heart disease is a consequence of all these risk factors.
So a person who is slim and trim and not obese is insured and protected from lifestyle diseases?
Not necessarily. A slim and trim person might be a smoker. You never know. Of course, in India or in Asians, we do have something known as invisible fat. So a person may not be appearing fat from outside, but his fat proportion might be high. So and his cholesterol levels might be high. So he might be more prone to get blockages in his blood vessels. So just being slim and trim does not mean that you are free from lifestyle diseases. If you are exercising actively and you are following a healthy lifestyle and you are slim and trim, then definitely you are protected yourself.